to show you something is happening, nothing is happening. Every single word you are hearing is ordained to make you to enjoy heaven on earth today, and that shall be your story. 2019 is our year of amazing restorations. That's what he has ordained to see happening this year. For everyone who will receive the word coming from this platform, amazing restoration shall be your portion in the precious name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
This month, we have been looking at amazing restorations by thanksgiving to the Father always. Ephesians 5 and verse 20. Ephesians 5 and verse 20 is a giving thanks always unto the Father by Christ Jesus. Giving thanks. We are not to give thanks sometimes. We are not to give thanks most times. We are to give thanks always. Always. Whether you think it is so or is a material, giving thanks always for all things to God and the Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, for giving us a commission called Jesus Mission Headquarters, Christ's Ambassador's Living Mission International. Giving thanks always for all things. I like this. It says all things are yours. 1 Corinthians chapter 3 and verse 21 and 23. All things are yours. He said, do not boast about men. Stop boasting about who you know. It doesn't matter. In God's scheme of things, who you know holds no water. The God you know is all that matters. The Jesus Christ you know is what counts. Who you know does not matter. He said, you shouldn't brag about men. Do not boast of man. 1 Corinthians 3 verse 21. Therefore, let no man glory in man. Don't boast about any man. For all things are yours. If God says all things are yours, you will be doing a foolish thing not to believe it. You know what I said? If God says, if a man who is in this house, we are in now, this apartment, comes and says, I am the owner of this house. I built this house. This house from today is yours. And people around hear it and never hear it. Take this document. This is a proof of ownership. Take, it's yours. You will take it because it's yours. True of us? True. If the owner of this house says, sir, this house from today is yours, take documents. This house becomes yours from that day. You never labor to build it, but because a man says so, who owns it? It becomes yours. The one who owns heaven and earth. He says all things are yours. If he says so, you will be a fool without him. If God says all things are yours, and he can never lie, let God be true, let every man be a liar. I will be a big fool to doubt God. Meanwhile, if a man says this house is now yours, I won't doubt that man. I won't doubt the man. If I can't doubt a man who may die, if I can't doubt a man who can change his word, how much of wisdom do I have to doubt God who can never lie and who can never alter his word? He said, the word has gone forth out of mouth and righteousness. He shall not return back for it. It is wisdom for you to give God thanks for all things. All things are yours. So give him thanks for all things. It may not matter. If the man gives me this house, I say, oh, thank you. I collect document, I say what? Thank you. That is to show I appreciate your gift. But God tells us all things are yours. We say we don't believe it. Yet we say we are believers and Christians. Are we not fools? God says, look at the Bible, sir, look at the Bible. 1 Corinthians chapter 3, 21. Therefore, let no man boast in men or glory in men, for all things are yours. Whether Paul or Apollos or Peter, Cephas, or the world or life or death or things present or things to come, all are yours. Now hear the end. And you are Christ's, and Christ is God's. So whatever God created and gave to the last Adam, Christ, through Adam, he has given it to us. Hey! Everything God created and gave to the last Adam, Jesus Christ, he has given us the same through Christ. Hear me? When God put Adam, the first Adam, in Eden and brought his wife Eve to him, Eve lived in Eden and enjoyed everything God made available to Adam in Eden. So, everything God has given to Christ, he, through Christ, gave to us his bride. So, whatever Adam had in Eden that Eve enjoyed qualifies every bride of Christ to enjoy right now. All God gave to Christ. So he says, all these are yours. If it is yours, thanksgiving is the only wholesome thing every reasonable, intelligent person should do. Gadaleon Grumbrak Dasketelero. I rejoice. You will hear. All things are mine. So giving thanks to the Father for all things. This is what you need to have all things. Amazing restorations will locate every thanksgiver who gives thanks and understanding. If the man says, son, this is your house, thank you, sir, I recollect it. God has said all things are yours. He has written a document called the Bible and signed the Bible into law with the blood of his son Jesus Christ. Men sign documents with Bible. The man will give me this paper. This is signed with Bible. But the book, the covenant God wrote, he signed it with the indelible blood of his son Jesus Christ. It makes more authentic than the current document of this house. The Bible is more authentic than any document can ever have, because this is sealed, signed and sealed with the blood of Jesus Christ. So no force can change it. No force. The man, they can go to the land registry and revoke the occupants of this place and take it back, even though it's to you. But the Bible, no force can revoke. I have a more authentic record. Man, I have a more authentic document. So I rejoice and I give God thanks. No force can stop me. I am taking back all that God gave Christ. If you like believe that, not that, your unbelievers, he doesn't change anything. He made me, he said, when I brought Eve to Adam in Eden, Eve had access to all I gave to Adam in Eden. Everything. And the last Adam is my husband. I am the bride. He as God brought Eve to Adam, he brought me to Christ. So where Christ is, that's what he said. God has delivered us, Colossians 1:13. God has delivered us from the power of darkness. He has translated us into the kingdom of the Son of his love. We have a new Eden that is better than Eden God gave to Adam. He said, giving thanks to the Father, Colossians 1:12, who has made us fit or qualified to partake of the inheritance of the saints in the light. That's our new Eden. The kingdom is our Eden. We have been qualified by God as Christ's bride to enter into where Christ lives and enjoy every single blessing God gave to Christ. So he said, all things are yours, and you are Christ's who owns all things, and Christ is God's who created all things. All things are yours, and you are Christ's who owns all things, and Christ is God's who created all things. So God the Creator gave all he created to the last Adam, and through the last Adam he gave me all as his bride. Why should I not thank him and enjoy what is mine? I'll be a fool not to appreciate my Father. That's why all we are doing today is to thank him with understanding. We thank him. This is what he has said. All the demons can change it. I have the document written that all things are mine, signed by God. And no force under heaven can revoke what he has said. No force. We're not playing here. No force can revoke it. So I have the most authentic proof that all things are mine. He says it's already here. He says in 2 Peter 1 and verses 2 and 3. He said, grace and peace be multiplied to you through knowledge. Grace and peace be multiplied to you through knowledge. If you are ignorant, you will never enjoy peace. Grace and peace be multiplied to you through knowledge. You can never have peace. You can never enjoy grace in ignorance. Many of God's sons and daughters are struggling, eating pigs leftovers because of lack of understanding. He said, according as his divine power had given to us all things. His divine power created all things. Satan stole all things from Adam. His divine power took over from the devil. What Satan took from Adam and gave back to us. His divine power has given to us all things without an exception. So all things are ours. Why should I not thank my father? Man, something is happening here. If you can get this revelation, you will never be under any lack. Where you are, see material. See material. It's see material. If I have been struggling to pay my rent and the landlord of this rent, he said, give me this in their house. It's yours. It's mine from that day. Yeah. From the very moment he says so and gives me a document that gives a proof it is so. Because if he says so and he is not the owner, nothing can happen. But if he's the real owner, man, it is so. But all things, who owns it? God. And he gave it to Jesus Christ. And through Christ, he gave me all. No devil can take from what is mine. So I thank him. Nothing. Go ahead and thank him right now. Just thank him. His divine power has given to us all things that pertains to life and godliness through the knowledge of him who had called us to glory and virtue. Just give him thanks for what he has done. Oh, we give you praise. Alianko, Sekona, Jalibane, Zida, Lovinko, De, Salio, Brodosh, Kanitazea, Lagana, Brendos, Teclolobro, Sunateria, Kanase, Rianko, Tese, Plele, Jacta, Nondolo, Frantelis, and Lolo, Praniscate. Oh, Father, we just give you praise. Thank you for all things are ours. Thank you for all things are ours. All things are ours. There is nothing any man can do to change it. All things. Jesus gave thanks, for you have given more things. We give you thanks in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Look at chapter 10 of Luke. As we wrap it up, Luke chapter 10, I read verses 21 and 22. In that hour, are you there? Jesus rejoiced in spirit and said, I thank thee, O Father, Lord of heaven and earth. Lord means honor. Lord is the word for honor. He said, I thank thee, O Father, owner of heaven and earth, that thou hast hid these things from the wise and prudent and hast revealed them to babes, even so, Father, for so it seemed good in thy sight. Verse 22. All things, how many things?
All things
are delivered to me by my Father. And no man, that was there. So they put colon in my Bible. Colon is an end of statement. Colon means end of statement. That's a fact. So what's the thing about it? All things are delivered to me by my Father. He gave thanks because God gave him all things. If God has given us all things, all we owe him is thank you.
That's it.
He said, no man knows the Father. No man knows who the Son is but the Father. And who the Father is but the Son. And he to whom the Son will reveal him. He has revealed the Father to me as he showed himself to me. What I'm telling you this morning is that no matter what you have seen so far, your era and seasons of deprivation and denials, they are ended forever.
Amen.
Your era of deprivations and denials are ended forever.
Amen.
In the precious name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Jesus gave thanks because the Father gave him all things. Now thank him for he has given all things. Just thank him.
Lord, I worship you.
Jesus was here. Nobody will see any bills account. But he knew he was in control. He knew he was in control. He knew he was in control. I know, as I know my name and my Father, I am in control. Lord, I just give you thanks and praise. All things are mine. You have made me fit and qualified to take part of what is mine. Glory be to your name. We just love you, Lord.
Den
kolen grangon gon front tenis again. La cochina to branene sila mayaba. Blessed be your name. For we have given thanks in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen. You may please have a seat. Hallelujah.